let grow to see the light. To see the light. And now at last, plain to see the happy dance of liberty. Liberty. Yeah. The world is black, the world is white, and turns by child is white. Together they grow to see the light. To see the light. The world is black. The world is white. It turns by day and then by night. The child is black. The child is black. The whole world looks upon the side. Shambala! Wash away my trouble, wash away my pain, when the rain comes down. Wash away my sorrow, wash away my shame, when the rain comes down.
Oh! certain songs that really lend itself to symphony music. I mean, because it's just like one, you know, or those. It really adds to it, an old-fashioned love song and those kind of songs that really add to it. And then when you take that a step further, and like in Liar that Danny does, and it gives it the power underneath it.
When we did Liar, Danny and I talked about this, and I said, can you do some of that, you know, boom, 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 you know, kind of like that war thing, you know, from the planets, you know, Holst, you know, and I said, yeah, I think that'll work really good. So I put an intro on that is very reminiscent of Mars from Gustav Holst, The Planets, you know, taking the elements. I always, you know, take the elements of the song, use the same harmonic progressions and using the information from the song Liar, but stylistically trying to achieve, you know, an orchestral sound that's reminiscent of, you know, another orchestral style, and then blend the two.
Kindred on bass and vocals, the tenor in the band, the guy with the high voice, yeah. And Patrick Batch on drums, Pat Petty.
Get away from the burn and the heartache. I walk to a bar by the
so much.
You know, I wanted to make a comment about the symphony music in our music, and I think the marriage is good because of today's, we're talking about the young people and the cutbacks and all the things that are going on in schools where music is being cut back, and not a lot of people want to go into the classics or go into the arts or go into, young people are not, they're losing people. The classic music are losing people because everybody wants to be a rock and roller. I mean, maybe that's just a sign of the times, but the point is, I think, by us doing this, it shows a lot of young people that that can still happen. You can still do that. You can still be part of music, current music, and yet still have that background and still be part of the classics.
Number. since you went away.
It's enough to make it light in the dark. It's
some Brickyard Blues.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
As all groups, all musicians and all groups go, you have your ups and your downs. And we went through a lot of downs after the heydays of Three Dog Night. And there were a lot of things that really cut into the creativity end of our music, for me, emotional stuff that happened. And you can't work and you can't create if you're under tremendous distress and emotional baggage that you carry around. And only in the last couple of years we're able to release ourselves from a lot of that stuff.
We stopped fighting.
Yeah.
We're like brothers.
I was trying to say that nicely, Dan, and you...
But
yeah, so and so that has caused us to get closer and to start cooperating and finding music again. It's fun again.
It works.
Souls are crazy questioning and hints can mean. This is the craziest party that could ever be. Don't turn on the lights, cause I don't wanna see no. Mama told me to come. Choking from the smell of stale perfume and a cigarette you're smoking. About to scare me into death. Open up the window, sucker. Let me catch my breath.
Mama told me to come. Mama told me to come.
Lord, she said it like this. She said it
like this.
Cory ever said to me, "Well, let's go out and find a kind of a thing with a country feel to it." I mean, just looked and heard songs and said, "That's a good song."
Yeah.
And we weren't really a political band, a lot, that was a big thing. The war was on and all of that. And we really just thought about music more than that. Maybe a little environmentally.
I got my shot in it because I was an environmentalist, but yeah. Out in the country.
But I kinda like the music. See the ladies all insane there. Yeah, they sure know how to use it. They don't abuse it. Never gonna do. Can't refuse it. Oh no. Well, I never been to England. But I kinda like.
all starts with a song.
Yeah, it's a song.
If you don't have
the song,
there's a million great musicians and singers out there, and if they're not singing a good song, there's some overproduced, wonderfully produced stuff, and if the song isn't there.
Right. Those writers back then, no one had ever heard of. Well, they did, but I mean, not the masses knew who Laura Nero was, or who Randy Newman was, or who Nielsen was, or any of those people that had written. And Elton John is one, for example. We did one of his very first songs that was sent to us. This was before he ever had your song or anything. Danny, actually, when we went to London, Elton came to see us, and he gave us that record for Danny to do. And Danny was recording. We were halfway done with it when he released it in the States.
Yeah.
And had that success with it. So those were unknown writers, and today we're doing the same thing. We're finding unknown writers right now, and we'll bring them to the forefront too someday. Who knows?
old-fashioned love song playing on the radio. And wrapped around the music is the sound of someone promising they'll never go. I've never really gone. Just an old-fashioned love song, one I'm sure they wrote for you and me. Just an old-fashioned love song, coming down in three-bar harmony to weave our dreams upon and listen to it cheer with the lights alone. To underscore our love affair with tenderness and feels that we've come to know. You swear you've heard it before, it slowly rambles on and on, and don't need bringing them back, cause I never read it gone. Just an old-fashioned love song, coming down in three-part harmony, yeah. Just an old-fashioned love song, one I'm sure they wrote for you and me.
Well, harmony now.
Just an old-fashioned love song, coming down in three-part harmony. Just an old-fashioned love song, one I'm sure they wrote for you and me.
Do we meet stream upon and listen to us sound?
Young girls ain't do get weary. Wearing the same old dirty funky dress. Ooh, why she gets weary? Won't you try? Won't try some tenderness? She's a beating for the things she'll never possess. Ooh, why she's weary? Won't you try for some tenderness? Yeah. trying. Oh, trying some tenderness. Yeah, yes. In the morning, yeah. Oh, the squeeze never leave it on. Want to love them. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're doing all right. You know she like. You know you love her. You know you hold her tight. Nobody know. You know she needs a tenderness. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, when it's late at night. Oh, when you're all alone. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You gotta touch her. You gotta squeeze a little bit. You gotta hold her in your arms. Yeah, yeah, baby. You know you got to love her. No, you got to love her. Love her. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Thank you so much.
I think Michael is probably the most underrated rock guitar player in the world. Probably one of the finest rhythm guitar players, I'm speaking my opinion, and a very, very good lead guitar player. He's a guy that in the studio can just throw out hooks all night. Sometimes we have to work on where to put them, but he's not, I call these young guitar players, these speed spaghetti guitar players that are so fast, but I don't think it's the old Ray Charles expression, learn when not to play. The guy is wonderful.
I agree about Michael on that too, but Jimmy is just a phenomenal individual. I've never met anybody like him. Not only does he have a photographic memory that can remember
every
detail from 35 years ago, but he is a talent that in his, what he's capable of doing musically, he gets bored quickly, and he's another one of those people that, and he has not, I don't think he's even explored his potential, what he could and can do on keyboards, and sometimes he needs a little prodding, and I think he needs to be pushed a little bit, but he is one hell of a musician, I'll tell you. I mean, there's no situation you could ever put him in that he could not play or be involved in.
He just needs a little medication.
Yeah.
Calm him down. Yeah.
Somebody's dream. Build a horizon as black as the sea. A four level highways across the land. Building a home for the family and man.
Do 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 do.
Prices are rising, the devil to pay.
So much.
Thank you.
bass and vocals, the tenor in the band. The guy with the high voice.
He was actually a phenomenal guitar player. And that's what he did for us the first round when he came to us in the 80s. He was the lead guitar player because Michael couldn't do it because of personal problems. And fabulous guitar player, which he still does on his own. But we gave him a proposition one day, and I called him and I said, Paul, we'd like to get you back in the band, and because he had made noises that he wanted to do that. And he said, oh, great, I'd love to
do it.
That's
the good news.
And here's the bad news. Can you play bass? He went, whoa, I don't know. He said, yeah, I guess I could. He said, it wouldn't be a big thing. How long do I have? I went, 2 weeks. So he went, that's a little short order, isn't it? I said, but if you can. So he had to like learn 15 songs in 2 weeks. Not only learn those songs, but had to learn how to play bass and learn those songs at the same time. And a great singer.
Pat Bowes, an incredible timekeeper. That guy is a metronome. The drummers we've had usually always, once in a while, somebody's going to slow down and speed up. This guy, he starts a record somewhere or on stage and it stays there. And he's got a great fun personality too.
Yeah.
He's up.
A cheerful, happy, never down.
Yeah.
And never
strange humor.
Yeah.
Living away, sitting on a pillow, waiting for night to fall. Girl in a dream, sitting on a pillow. This is the night, going to celebrity ball. Chandeliers, isn't it a pity? I didn't find time to go. Ready or not, gonna make it to the city. This is the night, going to celebrity ball.
Dress up tonight.
the groups have something, you know, that's unique to their style, and it's trying to pull that out and bring the orchestra to that and combine the two. And it usually, you know, because of the differences in, you know, in all the groups, it makes for, you know, you find that one ingredient, like this is unique to them, and, you know, to make that blend with the orchestra and work well. And that's a big challenge for me. And I think Three Dog does, you know, with having, you know, the lead singers that sing harmony, and the material lends itself really well to orchestra because, you know, they've had such great songs, you know, to work with.